Hello and welcome friends. Today I am going to say few words about Logit model, Probit model, Tobit model and Heckman sample selection two stage model. Let me start first with Logit model. Suppose you are going to investigate the socioeconomic factors that are influencing to buy a latest smartphone. Naturally, in questionnaire you may ask, do you want to purchase a latest mobile phone? The answer will be in yes or no. Now, you can set your independent variables are as income, age, gender, education, etc. for estimating the willingness to purchase or the probability of purchase with respect to the above mentioned socio-economic variable. You may apply logistic regression model or probit regression model. Now the Logit model assumes logistic probability distribution and the probit model assumes standard normal distribution. The logistic probability regression model may be written as follows. The probability of y conditional on the value of x1, x2, these are the explanatory variable up to k, equals to f bracket b0 plus b1 x1 plus b2 x2 plus dot 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 plus bk xk. And this ultimately can be written as 1 upon 1 plus e to the power minus b0 plus b1 x1 plus b2 x2 plus dot 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 plus bk xk. The left hand side, this side, shows the probability of 1, 1 means success, that means the respondent is willing to buy, conditional on the values of x, that is independent variables. The right hand side shows, that is f, shows the cumulative standard logistic distribution function, which has a specific functional form given by exponential function shown by the first line of equation 1. Now for estimating equation 1, we have to apply maximum likelihood method. After estimation through maximum likelihood method, we get the value, the coefficients beta 0 hat, beta 1 hat, beta 2 hat, etc. Now if you take a particular set of values from any respondent, any one respondent whose income is 10,000, suppose age is 27 years, education is 16 years, and he is his gender is male, that is given by numerical figure binary variable 1. Now you can calculate the probability of the cumulative standard logistic distribution function from equation 1, since you have the values of beta 1, beta 0, etc., coefficients value, and side by side the corresponding variable value of the variables. And ultimately it will be 1 by 1 plus e to the power something, which can be, you can calculate easily. So this is the expected probability of purchase given the values of the explanatory variables. Now you want to calculate the marginal effect, that is impact on the probability of purchase if there is any change, one or unit change of the independent variable. Now for getting marginal effect of any independent variable, say we are assuming that this is income, we want to calculate the marginal effect of income. Hence you have to raise the income level from 10,000 to 11,000, keeping the values of other variable unchanged, that is same as before. And again you have to calculate the value of the probability of cumulative standard logistic distribution function from equation 1, or the value of f. Now the difference of f value between these two cases shows the marginal effect of income, that is the probability of increase or decrease of buying a latest smartphone with an increase of income by one unit. Increase or decrease depends on the sign before that value. Therefore, the probability of purchasing that new latest smartphone will increase or decrease if there is a unit change in income is reflected by the marginal effect of income. Now similarly for other variables, for example gender variable, we have denoted male for 1 and female for 0. Now taking the values of the independent variables same as earlier, that is income 10,000, age 27 years, education 16 years, but instead of gender putting 1, now we put the value female as 0 and we can calculate F. The difference of the value of F between these two cases implies the difference of probability of buying a latest smartphone for a female, and then we can calculate the difference of probability of purchase between male and female. If you use stata, the stata command, import the Excel file in stata, then go to statistics, go to binary outcomes, logistic regression, provide the name of the dependent and independent variables, and then click OK. Now let us come to another model, that is probit model. The probit regression model can be written as in this mathematical, this is the mathematical expression, where the left hand side is the probability of y equals to 1, that is x1 conditional on the values of the explanatory variable, and the right hand side is the cumulative standard normal distribution function, the right hand side. Now by applying the maximum likelihood method for estimating the above probit model, we get the value of estimated coefficients. These are the estimated value of estimated coefficients, beta 0, beta 1, beta 2, up to beta k. Now by putting a particular set of values of the independent variable as mentioned above, that means income, 10,000, age, education, in this way, we can calculate the value of cumulative standard normal distribution, or the value of F, that is value of phi. We can able to calculate the value of phi. Suppose this value is phi 0.32. Okay. Now go to standard normal distribution table and get the value of, what is the value of 0.325 cumulative value. So the value, it is, suppose it is 0.6217. This implies, given the set of values of the independent variable as mentioned above, the predicted probability of having a latest smartphone is 62.17%. Now if we want to calculate the marginal effect of income, just change the value of income from rupees 10,000 to 11,000, keeping other values of the variable unchanged, and collect the table value of phi. The difference of the value of phi provides the marginal effect of income, that is the change in the probability of purchase if income changes by 1 unit. In this way, we can able to calculate the marginal effect of income using probit model. Now the stata command is same as import the Excel file in stata, then go to statistics, go to binary outcomes, go to probit regression, and provide the name of the dependent and independent variables, and click OK. Now let us come to the most important part, that is Tobit model. Logit and probit model consists of binary or dichotomous value of the dependent variable 1 or 0. But if you want to investigate how much money an individual willing to spend to buy a latest smartphone, knowing the respective values of the socio-economic variables, here the responses will not consist of 0 or 1, but 0, that means those who are not willing to purchase or willing to spend 0 amount of money, in that case, in those cases it will be 0, or any value of the dependent variable on the range of the price of the latest mobile phone. Hence, one part of the dependent variable is based on a discrete values and another part is continuous values. In other words, the distribution of the dependent variable is a combination of the continuous and discrete probability distribution. Since some values are discrete and some values are continuous, hence it is a combination of continuous and discrete probability distribution. Discrete means 0, that means minimum value, not willing to purchase this. So this is a combination of continuous and discrete probability distribution. Now, to solve the above problem, James Tobin, who is a Nobel laureate, developed a model which is known as Tobit model, in which the dependent variable takes some continuous and some discrete values. According to Tobin's model, the desired level of spending can be written as y star I equals to beta 0 plus beta 1 x 1 I plus beta 2 x 2 I plus dot 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 plus beta I x k I plus u I. Here y star I is the amount that the respondent is willing to spend for the latest mobile phone, and these are the x 1 x 2, these are the socioeconomic variables that are influencing this desired spending, and ui is the error term. The dependent variable y star I is also known as the latent or unobservable variable. In reality, the respondents have some internal potentiality or capacity or thought, whatever you can say, how can you express thought or desire to sacrifice the amount of money for the latest smartphone mobile. If this capacity exceeds his preference, that is the price of the model he is willing to purchase, he will definitely buy or spend for that model. Hence, his desired spending is equal to his actual spending, that is y star I equals to yi. But if his capacity or desire to spend is less than the cutoff, that means the minimum price of his preferred model, he cannot able to purchase or he will not buy this model. Hence, his actual spending will be zero. That is, mathematically can be written as this is the Tobin regression model. Yi, that means actual spending will be positive if the desired spending, that is y star I, is positive. In that case, desired spending will be equal to actual spending. But if the actual spending is zero, if the desired spending is zero or negative means not willing to purchase or something like this, that is, we don't observe any outcome. The distribution of desired spending looks like the figure in the next slide, that is given in this way. Distribution unobserved beyond the lower limit, or this is the lower limit, to the left of the lower limit, the distribution is unobserved, and the distribution is continuous. Distribution observed and continuous. So we do not actually observe this variable for all observations. We only observe it for those observations in which desired spending exceeds the cutoff marks. This is the cutoff marks or cutoff price, that is minimum price of the preferred mobile model in this case or in our example. Since some of the observations desired spending are known and some of the observations are not known, that is denoted by zero or spending zero amount, hence this type of sample is known as censored sample, censored from below in this case. Similarly, censored from above for a particular value is also possible. For example, I don't want to purchase the mobile if it is beyond the price of 80,000 or something like this. So 80,000 in that case will be the censored from right or upward censored. So the regression by taking such sample is known as censored regression model or limited dependent variable regression model. Tobin solved this censored regression model by applying maximum likelihood estimation method, and the OLS estimation does not provide the unbiased or consistent estimator. Equation 3 is known as Tobin regression model, as it is already mentioned. Hence, Tobin regression model is an example of censored regression model, since the dependent variable has been censored above or below a certain cutoff. The estimated coefficient of the Tobit regression model gives directly the marginal impact of an independent variable on the latent variable, but the statistical packages such as strata, e-views, R, etc. can compute the marginal impact of each regressor on the actual value also. The strata command is like this: import the Excel file in strata, then go to statistics, go to linear models and related, go to censored regression, then Tobit regression, give the name of the dependent and independent variable. And the important thing here is you have to provide at least one, that is either left or right censored or both censored value, and then click OK. Or write in the command section, go to the command section, write Tobit, the name of the dependent variable, the name of independent variable or variables if more than one independent variable is there, and LL0, lower limit is 0 if it is 0. Or in case of upper limit, you have to write UL, upper limit. For calculating marginal effect, you have to type MFX compute, comma, predict, bracket, Y star, bracket, 0, comma, dot, close the bracket, double bracket. Important part or related part of Tobit model is the sample selection model. Sample selection model can be again analyzed from the two angles. One is known as truncated regression model, another is Heckman's two-stage estimation. Let's start with truncated regression model. You know, in censored regression model, there are data with positive values, that means that is for buyers, and zero for non-buyers. Since these data are obtained by simple random sampling of the respondents, if in a data in which observations both the value of the dependent and independent variables are unobservable, when the dependent variable is above or below a certain cutoff or threshold, that is data with positive spending only, are called truncated data. Hence, regression model by taking only the truncated data is known as truncated regression model. The truncated regression model is an example of sample selection model, in which the selection mechanism is related to the value of the dependent variable. In our example, informations are only those respondent who are purchasing a smartphone, and value of the dependent variable means the price of the smartphone. The maximum likelihood method is applied to estimate truncated regression model. The strata command is import the Excel file in strata, then go to statistics, go to linear models and related, go to truncated regression, give the name of dependent and independent variables, and also provide at least one left or right or both censored value, then click OK. Or write in the command section trunc reg, name of the dependent variable, name of the independent variable, lower limit 0 if the lower limit is 0, similarly in case of upper limit also. Now the most important part of this video is the Heckman selection two stage model, type 2. This is also known as type 2 Tobit model. James Heckman has proposed an alternative to maximum likelihood method, which is comparatively easy. Heckman procedure yields consistent estimates of the parameters, but they are not as efficient as ML estimates. His method consists of two step estimating procedure. In step 1, we estimate the probability of success. In our example, the probability of buying a latest smartphone using Probit regression model. And in step 2, we estimate the Heckman selection model by adding it a variable called inverse Mills ratio, which is derived from Probit estimate. According to Heckman, Tobit model accounts for the probability of selection over and above the OLS estimation. But Tobit model, in Tobit model, we get only one marginal effect, that is one set of estimated coefficients that are accounted for two different behavioral equations or questions, behavioral questions. These two behavioral questions, one is behavior, that means according to our example, whether the respondent will buy or not, and the another one is selection. If the respondent buys, how much amount of money he or she will spend for the smartphone. Heckman provides some flexibility by treating these two questions in the mind of respondent. in the mind of respondents separately with potentially different set of variables and different set of coefficients for predicting these two outcomes, that is behavior, whether he will take the decision purchase or not. If he purchases, which model he will select, that is why it is selection. Mathematically, let Z be a matrix of independent variable and that are determinants of selection. If Si be a selection dummy, 1 means select the model, 0 means not select the model, and gamma is a vector of selection coefficients. Thus, Yi equals to x beta plus Ey if Si equals to 1 and Yi equals to 0 if Si equals to 0. So, the first model, that means that is denoted by, that is estimated through probit model, is the whether he will take the decision to purchase or not, that depends on socioeconomic variables. And the another variable, that means selection variable, that is probability of selection, depends on Z gamma plus Vi. If he selects, then there is the question of which model I will select. If he does not select to purchase, does not take the decision that to purchase, then this term will also be, there is no question of selection which model. Now, according to Heckman, both Ui and Vi distributed normally and they are jointly normal, where X is a strictly subset of Z. Hence, the Heckman two-stage regression model becomes like this: Yi equals to X beta plus delta lambda Z gamma bar plus Ey, where lambda is the inverse Mills ratio and it is estimated from first stage probit equation. If it is not statistically significant, it implies our selection probability term does not work in an unconditional expectation. Hence, the selection essentially is random and the term does not deviate from OLS, that is ultimately the result will converge to OLS. How can you apply this Heckman two-stage regression in Stata? You go to statistics, go to sample selection model, go to Heckman selection model, give the name of the dependent and independent variables as in the Tobit model for estimation. Now, for the second part, selection dummy, selection dependent variable, give at least one new independent variable in the cell of selection. Selection independent variable and suppress the constant term, then click OK. Or go to command space, type Heckman, give the name of the dependent variable, give the name of the independent variable, comma, select bracket original independent variables and give one or two new independent variables, bracket close, write two step. Unless you write two step, it does not work. Then click OK. In this way, we can calculate the estimation that is developed by Heckman. Now, for practical example, I have taken this data set. This is the COVID-19 cases per million population, that is number of infections per million population, death, COVID death per million population. These are the name of the different countries. This is the HDI value, Human Development Index value, and this value has been classified into very low level of development, high level of development, very high level of development in this way. Similarly, expenditure, that is percentage of GDP, health expenditure that the government is spending as percentage of GDP, physician per million population, hospital bed per million population, inequality of income, age 65 and above. In this way, the data set has been collected, so selected. Now we want to apply as an hypothetical example in the Tobit regression model. So go to Stata, go to Stata, go to statistics, then go to linear model and related, as already mentioned. Go to sensored regression, go to Tobit regression. The give the name of the dependent variables, death per million, and the independent variable is health expenditure, inequality of income, and the level of development. So we want to investigate, does the death per million population, number of death, is the result of the government expenditure on health, inequality of income, or the level of development. But you have to give left censored at minimum, or you can put here at any particular specified left censored. In our case it is zero, because there are some nations whose death is zero. Okay, there is no right censoring limit. Click OK. This is the result of Tobit regression. If you write in the command also this command, Tobit death million, that means dependent variable, write the independent variable and lower limit as zero. So this is, this regression shows that health expenditure is positive, is significant and positive, and inequality of income is not significant. The development level, that means the base category or reference category, is the number one. The one means the very high level of development. So, and this is very low level of development. This is, all the values are significant. This implies that the very low levels, nations with very low level of developments, death rate is less compared to the very high. Less means 129 less. Similarly, for medium level of development nations, the death rate is less than or compared to the high level, very high level of developed nations, by 115 units. Similarly, for the high compared to very high. In this way, we can explain the Tobit model. 10 is the 10 censored observations. Now, we want to show how can we calculate the Heckman's two-step estimation. Go to statistics, go to sample selection model, go to Heckman selection model two-step, click, give the dependent variable. For this is for the first stage, dependent variable same as it is in the Tobin or Tobit's model, death per million, health expenditure, the development level, inequality of income, that is whether death will take place or not. Now go to selection dummy, the number of deaths, possible deaths. You have to put additional variable. Here we have taken number of physicians per million of population and number of hospital beds per million of population as additional independent variable. Then click OK. So this is the result for Heckman two-step estimation. This two-step is related to the first step, is whether death will take place and the role of the independent variables for taking the death. And the second stage is the selection, the number of deaths, possible death, with respect to these variables. So here again, the physician per million, negative, coefficient is negative, though statistically not significant. Hospital bed per million population, negative. That means as the number of physician increases, the death level will decline. Similarly, as the hospital bed increases or the health infrastructure increases, death level will decline. Inequality is negative and insignificant also. And the lambda, that means inverse means ratio, is not significant, insignificant. This implies that selection variable is random. Okay, so it is just, we have explained in our last command that this is selection probability term does not work in an unconditional expectation. Hence, the selection essentially is random, and this term does not deviate from the OLS that is the result. So that's all for today, friends. Thank you for your patience hearing.